cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind.
And welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, we're gonna be doing a first impressions on a few little goodies that I picked up from Sephora when they had a 30% off sale for Halloween, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, I picked up, it's not a full face, but just a few bits and pieces that I thought I might as well try it on camera so I can show you guys how I feel about it. And looks like we are bringing back the thick brows, so I'm so sorry. I will try and conceal them and try and make them look a bit thinner, and then excuse my really bad fake tan finger. I have no idea what happened to this, but just fake tan last night, so don't mind that. Enough talking here. If you like seeing my videos or like watching me, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. It definitely helps me out a lot. And if you want to be notified whenever I make a video, don't forget to click the notification bell just above this video as well, and comment if you want to see anything that you want me to film and upload. I will try and do my best to do that for you. But let's just get right on to the video. So I'm just gonna start with concealing underneath my brow, and I'm gonna be using my Ride or Die, the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade 10. I'm absolutely obsessed with this concealer. I've been using it ever since I bought it, and it's just such a good concealer. It's a dupe to the NARS Soft Radiance Concealer. I can't remember what it's called. But I can't afford $40 for a concealer, so I'd rather pay that $20 for a concealer, because half the price, it still does an amazing job. Not going to lie, I am not liking in these thick brows. Lately, I've been doing nice, like, skinny, natural-looking eyebrows, but today my eyebrows are just not working out. They do not want to crop right, so I was like, you know what, stuff it, I'm just gonna leave it. So next I'm going to move into eyes, and today I'm going to be using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Prism Palette. Now this is my first ever Anastasia Beverly Hills product I've ever bought from makeup, which is a surprise. Like, I don't even have the Modern Renaissance palette, but I think it's pretty similar to the Huda Beauty Rose Gold palette, and I have that, so I don't know, I kind of don't need the same colours on a different palette. But yeah, so I'm really excited to try this out, because I'm really excited to try out a Throne and Pyramid, which is really catching my eye. And it also comes with this brush as well, which is like double ending. I have dipped into the black before, that's because I really needed a black, and that black was so damn pigmented, which I was really surprised. Oh, it's dug into the shadow. Jesus Christ. I'm just going to take this Morphe Y17 brush, and I'm just going to dip into Satin, which is this like orange shade, and I'm just going to put this into my crease. I couldn't get over how this palette was 30% off. As soon as I saw it, I was like, get in my basket, I need you. Now, I have heard a lot of mixed reviews about this palette. I thought I might as well give this one a try, because I love the colours in it. Like, I don't think I have any of these colours in any other palette. And I'm just going to try and blend out the edges so they're not so harsh. Yeah, I'm just going to go in for a little bit more. So far, it's blending really, really nice. It's got good pigment. And I like how you can build up the shade as well, so it's not going to be too harsh. First, you need to put it on the eye. Once I'm happy with how that looks, I'm going to take my BH Cosmetics number 6 brush from the Aurora set, and I'm going to dip into Parallel, which is this brown shade here. And I'm just going to stick this right into my crease. I'm thinking about doing a halo eye today. So wish me good luck for that. I'm going to take my BH Cosmetics number 9 brush from the Marble set. I'm going to dip into that just so it's a bit more fluffier, so it's easier to blend out. That shadow did take a really long time to blend out. It was quite harsh and doesn't really look like the shade in the palette either. It looks a lot more like a grey black instead of like a nice warm brown. But I'm gonna go back with that Morphe Y17 and go back into Satin, just because I do want it a little bit more warm. And I'm just gonna go right above parallel. I'm now just gonna take a big fluffy brush from BH Cosmetics and just blend out the edges of that color we just put down. And I'm just gonna repeat this a few times just until I get the combination that I want. Okay, thinking about this, I don't know if this color combination is gonna work, but I really want to try out those two colors here. So I'm gonna take the shade Throne and I'm gonna use this on a Weaver 226 smudger brush. I'm just gonna pick that up and put it on the outer and inner corner of my eye. Oh well, I didn't even wet my brush. And look at the pigment. I'm gonna pick up my brush I use for parallel, which is my BH number 9 brush from the marble set. I'm gonna dip in the tiniest bit of that and just try and blend out the edges. I'm gonna go back in with Satin and try and warm up this look a little bit more. Okay, I'm just gonna grab my concealer brush, which is just this flat round brush. And I'm gonna take my concealer, but this time I'm gonna take it in the shade 5. And I'm just gonna cut my lid to how I would have it for a halo eye. I'm just gonna dip into the shade Pyramid and I'm gonna take this on a BH Cosmetics number 9 brush from the quartz set. I'm just gonna put that where I put my concealer. Okay, not the best look I've created. I feel like I could have done better, but it's gonna be good enough for now. I'm just gonna do the other eye off camera and add some lashes, and I will be right back. So my eyes are all done. Not the happiest with it, but you know, it will do. So I haven't got any new face products, so I'm just gonna go in with my usual routine. So I'm gonna be using my Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the shade 220. And I'm just gonna apply that to my face. My foundation is still a bit light for me since I just fake tanned. So I'm gonna do some dots on my face of that foundation. Then I'm gonna go in with my NYX foundation drops, which is in the shade 16.5. And I'm just gonna go a little bit like that. Now I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade 15. Hey guys, I'm so excited that I'm now on school holidays. So for my school, we get a 3-month holiday if you're in year 11, which is the year I'm in, because I am currently 16 years old, but I'm so close to turning 17, and you have no idea how excited I am. I just want to get my license already so I have freedom, because all I want is freedom. I'm sick of having to catch the bus and train everywhere and getting abused if you look at someone for too long. And then my boyfriend also lives, it's like a 45 minute drive for me, so I prefer driving it than taking it 2 hours on the bus and train. Or even on hot days when you just want to like go somewhere, but instead of walking for ages trying to find like a bus or train, you can just drive it. And you need aircon as well, which is so good. Anyone else feel like this year's gone so quick? Like, I feel like this year I've completed or accomplished so much already. Like, I never would have thought I would have a YouTube channel up and running. And then I also completed my TAFE course as well, which is very exciting. I never thought this year would go that fast. If you guys don't know what I was doing in TAFE, I was doing a retail cosmetics Cert 2 course. I was going to do my Cert 3 this year, but it's just too much and I want to do YouTube. Like, I don't want to do anything else. Like, I can't see myself doing anything else. And it's like, there's no point wasting money if I know I'm not going to do that in the future. And I already work in retail, so it's not like I really need the Cert. So now I'm just going to set everywhere a crease with my favourite Laura Mercier powder. I'm so excited, guys. Maybelline has finally released the Maybelline Fit Me Translucent Powder in the stores in Australia now. And you have no idea how excited I am to try it out. I'm pretty sure they've only got it in Priceline at the moment. I'm not sure about like Target or Big W or Kmart. And to set the rest of my face, I'm just gonna take my big fluffy glamour brush with my Charlotte's Fresh and Flawless powder in darkest brown. And I'm just gonna press that into my face. All time favorite powder I've ever used. I don't think I told you what eyelashes I'm using. The eyelashes I've been using is the Angel Wing lashes, and these are in the style Mary Jane. I'm just gonna finish off the eyes, and I'm gonna take the shade Satin with my Morphe Y17, the brush I was using earlier, and I'm just gonna smoke out my lower lash. And then I'm gonna take my BH Cosmetics number 6 brush, and I'm just gonna go in with Parallel, which is that brown shade that we used. And I'm just gonna put this really close to my lash line. Anyone else do weird things with their mouth when they try and do like their lower lash line? Even though you don't have to, it just feels comfortable too. And I'm just gonna blend those two together with a big fluffy brush. On the mascara I've been using lately that I've been loving, this is the Essence Lash Princess Mascara, the False Lash Effect Mascara. And it is so freaking good, guys. It's like, I think $6.50. And it's so good. Especially for the lower lashes. Because like my lower lashes right now, they look so good. Usually you can't see them. And then you use this and it's like, bam, instant eyelashes. So next we're gonna go on to contour. And I picked up this bad boy. So this is the Marc Jacobs 40 Mirage Filter Instant MAC Light Filtering Contour Powder. That is a mouthful. But it looks like this. This is my first ever Marc Jacobs product. Guys, I never would have even thought I would be able to afford Marc Jacobs, but thank God that Sephora has Afterpay, so my money is going somewhere good. This is what it looks like. So it's got like a contour powder on one side. So I'm trying not to blind you guys. But it's got a contour powder on one side and then like a banana shade next to it. So I'm just gonna take my favorite contouring brush, which is my BH number 4 brush from the Quartz set. Yes, it's a bit dirty. Don't mind me, I'm a bit gross. I'm gonna dip into that. I don't know how pigmented it is. I'm just gonna go with like a soft hand. I like how it's quite subtle, but it still defines the areas you want to define. And it's not too grey either, which I appreciate, because mostly every contour I use is so grey. But look at the finish shimmery. Love that. I'm gonna go in with my usual bronzing powder, which is my MAC Give Me Sun, and I'm just gonna use this with my Morphe Y2 brush. Favorite bronzing brush as well. It's just so nice and fluffy and gives you like a nice even application. I'm just gonna bake underneath my contour just to help refine it a little bit. So while that's baking, I'm just going to add some blush. So I'm going to use my usual L'Oreal Lives of Peach blush. Absolutely obsessed with it. Best blush I've ever used. And I'm just going to use this on my BH Cosmetics number 1 brush. And put it on the apples of my cheeks. I'm just going to wipe off that bake now. Just going to have some sitting there for a little bit. I don't want my contour too intense. I'm just gonna try and blend out contour as well, so it's not so harsh. Okay, I've got this liquid highlighter from Tarte. I'm scared to put this on top of my foundation. I should have put it on before, but I just forgot about it. I got mine in the shade Stunner. I just put a little bit in my hand. What? That is so pretty. Why has no one ever talked about this before? Well, at least I haven't heard anyone talk about that. Whoa! That is so pretty. I love that. I've taken the tiniest bit. I'm just gonna dab it on my cheekbones. Okay, I'm just gonna try and blend that in with my beauty blender. Oh, did I slap my makeup up? No. Yeah, I should have put it on after I did my foundation concealer. I just forgot about it. God damn it. It's really pretty though. It's just stuck in my face and my blend. Okay, I'm just gonna have to put the same on the other side just so it looks even. Man, I knew I should not have done that. Definitely gonna try this on top of my concealer and foundation before I set it next time. So for setting spray, I got the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Marine Boosting Mist. And this is from Tarte. Okay, I'm just gonna spray my face. So for highlight, I'm going to take the Tarte Skin Twinkle Lighting Palette. So it comes with three highlighters, which is called Sunlight, Filtered Light, and Moonlight. This is what it looks like. It's very, very pretty. I'll swatch them for you. I haven't tried these out yet, so I've been waiting. Been waiting for this video. Okay, this middle shade is so dry, so I don't know if that's meant to be a highlighter or like face powder. This first one is Moonlight, middle one is Filtered Light, and the next one is Sunlight. Yeah, it says that Moonlight is a champagne gold. The middle one is a matte sand, so I'm guessing it is meant to be like a face powder. And then the other one is a rosy pearl. So I might go in with Sunlight. Since I've got gold on my lid, I want to complement the gold. I'm going to take my BH Cosmetics number 4 brush from the Aurora set, which is my favourite highlighting brush. And I'm just going to use that to highlight my cheekbones. Oh wow, that is stunning. It's like taking off my foundation on this side, and I have no idea why. Okay, I'm just gonna try and blend it in with my bronzer, just so I don't have that harsh highlight line. Then taking my Morphe Y22, I'm just gonna use this to highlight my nose, my inner corners, and underneath my brow bone. So I picked up 3 lipsticks. So this is my first ever Anastasia Beverly Hills lipstick. This is in the shade Caramel. I thought it was gonna be more of a brown, but it's quite yellow. It's quite pink. That's what it looks like. I've also got my Tarte, I think it's from the Rainforest collection as well, and this is in the shade Buff. This is like a nice nude. You can barely see, it's like a lip gloss type thing, which is quite pretty. And then I've got my Tardigan's Lip Paint and Tarte Lipstick, which is in the shade Vibing, so it's like a little mini, which is quite cute. I got it for free since I spent over $100, I think. But it's like this really nice dark red maroon shade. Since I'm already pretty dark on the eyes though, I might go with more of a nude shade. So So I'm going to try out that Anastasia Beverly Hills lipstick. It's quite pink, so I might go over the top with my Tarte lipstick because it's a bit more nude. See if that will cancel out the pink. No, it's just making it glossy. I might go change it for a different lipstick just because I want more of like a nude shade instead of like a pink shade. I'm just going to use my NYX Liquid Suede Liquid Lipstick in the shade Sandstorm. Yeah, I feel like that's a lot better, goes a lot more with my look I wanted. So this brings me to the ending result of today's look. It is quite different. I'm not really happy with the eyeshadow, I'm not gonna lie. Like I love the eyeshadow palette, I just don't like the look I created, if that makes any sense. But I feel like next time I'll probably create a different look that might look a lot better. But yeah, I'm overall pretty happy with the products. I just wish I tried the liquid highlighter before I set down my face, which is my fault, it's not the product's fault. So I will give it another try next time. And the lip products were nice, just a bit too pink for me because I do like more of a nude colour. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I love filming this type of video to show you guys how I feel about different products. But yeah, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down the channel if you want to see more of my videos. And don't forget to hit the notification bell at the top if you enjoy watching these videos and want to be the first one to watch it. I hope I see you guys on the next video. Bye guys.